Of course, so I wanted to make a more complete video about the Iskall Queen Cessna, so I decided to put all the information into one video. Well, almost every piece of information. Now, the Queen is kind of hard to find, so you need to reset the adventure about 10 or 20 times depending on your luck. She is usually in the second area of the map, meaning you have to kill a boss and then go and open the door. She might be there or she might be somewhere near there. Depends, but just search all the map. All of the map. Now, if you kill her any or interact with her, you can get a lot of stuff. For example, if you kill her the normal way, you will get her pistol, the Pride of Iskall. If you kill her the sneaky way, you'll get the Seeker mode, which is 5 beetles maximum with corrosive damage and explode on touch. Yeah, they're suicide beetles. If you get the Cryptolith, which you automatically get it. So the first time you meet the Queen in Adventure mode, you get the Cryptolith Sigil. And with this thing, you can go on the map and search for the obelisk with the shining light. I'll show you at the end of the video the obelisk. And you can get a few traits. If you kill the queen, you get the footwork. The first time you use the cryptolite on the obelisk, you get concentration. And the second time, blood bond. Weird. And the third time you use the cryptolite on the obelisk, it will actually disappear from your inventory. And you have access to the labyrinth, where you get the labyrinth set, which is a cool set. I'll show off the labyrinth set after I kill the queen the alternative way. Now this is how I charge my weapon power. If you don't have my weapons or my loadout, probably you can use the devastator or the... By the way, they have a scope. Particular accelerator has a scope, ruin has a scope, sniper rifle has a scope. It will be easier for you to hit her in the head in the first phase with a scope, or you can just go very very close to her with a spore bloom. Yeah, but after I charge up my mod power for my guns, I usually switch to the radiant set. Or you can actually do it even in the Leto set. Let's actually do it in the Leto set. You don't need to dodge that much anyway, so let's try it with this one. But in case you don't have a Leto set, you can do it in a heavy armor because it's easier if you don't die in 2 hits. Or even the Osios set, or even the Void armor, because again, you need a lot of protection against corrosion and also to be able to, you know, deal some damage. Even though this is bad for corrosion, it has defensive stack anyway, it's easier for you if you use it like that. Now, instead of the Gift of Iskall, I'll actually use the Celerity Stone for once, because this is a very hard boss. Okay, well, almost ready. As you can see, I have all the buffs. Well, almost all of them. Sorry about the longer talking, but you kind of need to know a lot of things, because you need to fight her at least 2 times to get all the stuff and find the obelisk a lot of times. So, yeah, you might want to kill her the normal way. And then start searching for the obelisk, and if you find her, a second time you can kill her the alternative way while searching for the obelisks. Okay, let's get ready. I mean, she's not so tough. The only problem will be if I miss the alternative kill. By the way, as an alternative to the shock damage, if you don't want to use that, use the Twisted Idol, because that will give you even more armor. Okay, the first part is easy if you use this particular build. So you'll put down tentacles in the middle of the room and then you'll just shoot at her until you get bored. Sounds like fun, right? So spread them out a little bit. Use the powder and then start shooting. And after you reload, just shoot again with the lightning at her. Okay, now actually see where the water is dropping on the floor with the stalactite. And let's prepare for the alternative kill. Remember, you will have to push her back a little, so positioning is key here. So don't rush it. Perfect. By the way, she wears no pants, in case you didn't know. Okay, that was kind of rough, but it's kind of like the full fight and the full steps. As you can see, I didn't take a lot of damage, because if you have over, let's say, I don't know, 50 armor or something like that, 500 armor, you won't take much damage. But because of the corrosion... Corrosion actually reduces your armor by almost 50%, so that's why you'll take a lot of damage. So if you're using light armor, basically when corroded, and it's very easy to get corroded, you'll basically have almost no armor. So in a way, it's better to fight naked if you know what I mean. Anyway, this stays over there for a while. Now let me show you the labyrinth armor. And we'll go to the obelisk, because I said I'll show you the obelisk as well. Ta-da! Also, let me show you her pistol more clearly. Now we really look like an alien. It's more like a burst pistol, so yeah. Meet your maker. Anyway, the game is fun, but I feel like some of the bosses are way, way overtuned, especially her, because of her corrosion effect. It's almost impossible not to get corroded. And since I already have the place... Wait. Return to the ward. And since I already got to the obelisk the first time, it's quite easy to get there. I just have to teleport there. The queen has many secrets, so I think in total we can get 7 stuff from her, 7 items or traits or skills. I'll do another video for the one that I mentioned if you go infected, and I'll also do one for her throne outside the palace. Teleport over there, bingo. So as you can see, the queen is actually the one with the most items and the most content in the DLC, so yeah, we'll have to kill her a lot of times for that. And sometimes you'll just kill her for fun, because you hate her. You really, really hate her. So this is how the obelisk looks. Remember, the obelisk can spawn on each planet. Actually, I'm not sure about Yaesha, but I saw it on Earth and on Rome. So, if you interact with the cryptolith sigil on it, meaning you find the queen on adventure mode or you play in campaign and give her the guardian heart, you'll get the trait. So the second time you'll get this trait, and the third time a portal will open for you to get the labyrinth armor. So let's see what happens if you interact with it without, while having the traits. Oh, you get 900 scrap and the trait points. So even if you don't, that's actually pretty good. Even if you already uncovered it and you're doing this for the second time, if you just see the obelisk, just go there and activate it for the scrap and the level up. Well, that's kind of everything I wanted to show you about the queen. But let's actually play a little more with this. Let's play a little more with this gear so I can show you. Since the armor is pretty much paper thin because it's not upgraded, I'll die in a few hits, but I guess that will be enough to show you how it plays and what you do with it. This all picks up the scrap and materials automatically, like iron, that is. Increase total weapon mod damage. Well, to be honest, let me show you this little baby. Since this increases the weapon mod damage, the gravity core will do so much damage if you shoot at that enemies right now. Let's see, where is the bigger... Oh, okay, let's go over here. So you deal damage... They do damage on hit, and also they do damage after they explode. Actually, hit me once, oh. This guy will surely kill me. Okay, that was close. Now, they heal almost for full HP, because no matter how much HP you'll have, you'll never have over 200. So let's get it once. And then run away. And after a little while, they'll come and heal you. Chom chom chom. I like that sound they make, see?
Who's next?
Full HP. Now, you know the gravity core and what it does, so let's just shoot it on a normal enemy. Oh, there is an elite enemy over there. Let's see how much damage it does. 3000 damage. Well, it can do even more than that if you have the right items and the right set equipped. I mean the right trinkets and the right weapon, but considering it normally does 1400 damage. Wait. Let's actually charge it up again so you see how fast it is with the new ring. So you basically need to only kill a few enemies and you can still wear the set. Come on. Okay, so we're almost ready to use it again. So you can basically use it every minute or so. So even with this build and if you level up the armor, see, it automatically comes at you. Okay, let's punish this guy really bad. Damage. The range is actually very big on the pickup. It doesn't really pick up the ammo because again it's not resources, so only scrap and iron. Okay, let's try it like this. It's just throwing the scrap at you and that's what I like about it. Let's see if we can find a little more crate so I can play around with it a little more. Okay. It actually staggers if you shoot it a lot of times, so even if it doesn't kill straight away because it's not upgraded, it still staggers a lot. And even if the enemy doesn't have full HP, you still get a lot from draining them. Oh, I'm too close. And then the loot just comes to you. Anyway, that's all I wanted to show you, and to be honest, it's a really good expansion. I hope you'll have fun with it. Bye!